Welcome to deepTalk. My name is Caroline. Let's learn about the conversation page in deepTalk. First, log into your account. From the dashboard, I'm going to open a previous conversation. At the top of the screen are key statistics of the conversation. There's the total number of words and the number of words per minute, the intensity of the conversation, the number of action items, and the level of productivity. Further, we can see the date and time the conversation took place, the title, topics, and the attendees. There is even a field to enter your agenda. All of these fields can be edited at any time. The topics are automatically generated and will appear when the conversation is over. Topics represent a high-level overview of the conversation. These topics will also appear on the dashboard for convenience when searching. You can add topics manually by clicking Add Topic. If you work in Teams, you can share this conversation with your teammate by adding them as an attendee. All you need to do is select the person from the drop-down list. You can add attendees manually as well, but if they are not part of your team, the conversation would not be available for them. You have the ability to delete attendees too, if you so choose. In the top right corner of this section, deepTalk allows you to download these meeting notes into a Word document. On the right is a transcript of the entire conversation, which is also available for a quick download to a Word document. The icon in the lower right corner can be used to scroll down, which is especially helpful for lengthy transcripts from longer conversations. You can search for specific text in the transcript by using the Command F feature on an Apple computer or Control F on Windows. And you can copy text from the transcript at any time. Next, in the lower left, we have a summary of the conversation. This consists of both automatically generated and manually added action items. If I click on this automatically generated action item, you can see that deepTalk set the due date based on the speaker's action item needing to be completed the day before. Another great feature is that the automatically generated action items can be located in the transcript, as you can see here on the right that the action item text is highlighted blue. A small icon in the right continues to point out that an action item is located here in the transcript. Plus, if you look at the very bottom, there is a recording of the entire conversation. Clicking the action item button will take you to where in the recording the action item was created. If you click the play button for the recording, you will notice that the text of the transcript is highlighted in accordance with the audio. As I move the audio slider back and forth, it follows along with the exact words of the transcript. Next to the option to manually add action items, you can manually add decisions or notes. Notes are private by default, so nobody except you can see them. You can share notes with attendees by changing the status to public. Be aware that private notes will not appear in downloaded Word document reports. The last thing is that you can start a new conversation by clicking the microphone button on the left. And that is everything you need to know about the conversation page. Thank you for choosing deepTalk as your smart meeting assistant.